Previously on Kyle XY.
Adam wanted me to give you this.
It's a ring.
That's a beautiful stone.
I'll be back for that.
It's not in there, kid. Your ring? I sold it.
Well, who bought it?
Welcome to Metacorp.
I think I made a mistake bringing Jesse to you. I think it's vital that she continue coming. In fact, if Jesse misses even one appointment, I won't hesitate to call social services.
Because I like you. Don't you like me?
Well, yeah.
Let's count to three and both say what's on our minds at the same time.
I like you. Answer.
What?
Scissors, that's a way in. This is Balin's. Can't get it open.
Locks imply secrets. The stronger the lock, the bigger the secret. Adam Balin's secrets are locked inside this box. The secrets of Zizix are locked inside my head. But what could be so important to make me lock them away and keep them a secret from myself? I guess sometimes the only thing more elusive than secrets is the key to unlocking them. In this case, the key was the ring that Adam gave me. The ring I no longer had.
I just don't understand what's so important that's locked inside Kyle's head.
Everything that Zizix was able to feed him. That is, before you could fit their remains in an ashtray. How did your trip with Stephen Traeger go?
It went well. He opened up about his dead father. I'd say we bonded.
And how were things with Nicole since your altercation?
We'll find out. She has another session with Jesse in a couple of days.
We need to speed things up.
Drop the spoon and back away from the stove. Nice and easy.
Come on, I'm starving. It's your fault this stuff smells so good.
I think there was a compliment in there somewhere.
Pasta. Most delicious of all car delivery systems.
Yeah, it's an old family recipe.
How old?
About 53 minutes. Oh, I need you to set an extra place at the table. Amanda is joining us.
Kyle invite her?
Yes, he's very excited, and whatever the Kyle version of nervous is.
Great, Kyle has a date. Bye-bye leftovers.
Josh, this is important to him.
Hey, Josh, why don't you invite Andy over for dinner?
What, no smart-ass reply? What's next, Locust?
Hey, guys.
We have a guest for dinner. This is my boss, Julian Ballantyne. Sorry to spring this on you. I didn't get a chance to call.
Oh, no, don't be silly. It's so nice to finally meet you, Mr. Ballantyne.
Bye-bye, seconds.
This is Josh and Lori.
Good to meet you, and please call me Julian.
Nicole.
I brought red and white. You know what you'd be serving.
Well, I like red. I will when I'm 21.
I heard the door is a mansion.
Oh, you must be Kyle. I heard so much about you from Steven.
Yeah, we work together at Metacorp.
Excuse me.
You have to forgive Kyle. Tonight's kind of a date.
Hi. You look beautiful.
I didn't know what to wear. I wasn't sure how fancy it would be or not. So I...
You wore what you were wearing the first time I saw you. When you were playing the piano.
I had no idea. Wait, how could you even remember that?
How could I forget it?
Well, I almost forgot. There's this concert at Seattle, Phil. They're playing all Pachelbel's works, and...
I'd love to. Go if you want me.
You know, I almost brought champagne, but I figured we'd save that till after the test this week.
What test?
No, it's a systems integration test. We bring all the software and hardware online together at the same time, and we sync it all up to the mainframe and evaluate the biometric signature compatibility.
So you're turning neural impulses into computer data?
Yeah.
Sounds like you understand this stuff better than I do.
You know, maybe I should have served dinner with a manual.
I don't know what I did before we had Steven around, but after this week, I promise I won't keep him away from you any more than absolutely necessary. I figure Emily can handle the next trip solo.
Oh, Emily went with you last weekend?
Yeah, she's part of the project.
I'd like to propose a toast, if I may. Steven, and your wonderful family, whom I hope I get to know much better in the future.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Possession of a ring, Balin's ring, that you pawned. A ring that just so happens to be the only way of opening Balin's box that you happened to dig up out of that underground death trap. But I think there's no such thing as coincidence.
I knew this talk to Voss about this.
Balin told you not to trust him.
Balin told me not to trust Taylor. I think Taylor switched the message.
Whatever. You can't just sit back and wait for Foss's blessing.
Amanda, it's Kyle. He's gonna be thrilled no matter what you wear. Trust me, if I wear something lame, he'll remember it. Okay, what's the matter?
I got a letter from this conservatory in New York. I applied there a long time ago to study piano. And I kind of got in.
That's awesome. Ugh, I would kill to get to go to New York.
And I'm totally excited. It's just... It's for a whole semester and...
The long distance thing. Explains your attention to detail.
Yeah. Am I crazy to think it could work? I mean, it's three time zones away.
With any other guy, I'd say don't waste your any time minutes, but it's Kyle. He spent the last year pining over you from a distance. I'm sure one semester won't even make a dent.
Dig in. Don't worry. There's like zero nutritional value in that.
No thanks.
I can go back and get a turkey club if you'd rather have that.
Gosh, my stomach's kind of on edge. I have a test tomorrow.
Oh. Well, fear not. I got a laser printer that can print, like, nanoscopic, so I can make you the primo cheese sheet.
It's not that kind of test, Josh.
Oh. You mean...
It'll tell the doctors if I need more chemo.
Right. You should get some popsicles then. No, I was reading online that chemo makes you really dehydrated, and one thing that helps is popsicles.
Josh.
No, seriously. What flavors do you like? You know, just in case the cancer's back.
Please don't use the C word. The other C word. Remember when I said you couldn't talk to anyone about this? Well, that includes me. Homework?
Oh, God, it feels like it. We got the systems integration test coming up.
Right. Well, Valentine sounded very impressed with you. So, hey, you never really told me about your business trip. You know, San Francisco.
Oh, well, it was good. It was work. But it was good. And after everything that happened with my dad, it was just nice to get away.
Lori, could you get that?
Hello?
Well, I'm glad you got a break.
Yeah, and, well, as it turns out, Emily's got a few issues with her father, too. She really understood.
Well, I'm glad you had someone to talk to.
Phone for you.
Oh, thanks, hon.
Hello.
Emily. Hi. What's up? Really? That's good news. But, hey, that's why we get paid the mid-range bucks. Absolutely. No problem. All right, you too.
Scared me. Who was that?
Gosh, someone from work. Listen, I'm gonna go take a shower, okay?
Just promise me you won't disassemble the mainframe.
I didn't like misleading Steven, but Declan was right. I couldn't just sit back and do nothing. I had to face Valentine on his own ground to try and figure out what we were up against.
Kyle. You have no idea how delighted I was to hear you were coming to Matacorp with Stephen. What brings you here today?
Research for a project.
Oh, it must be very important if they let you out of school.
There's a lot riding on it.
Well, I hope I can lend a hand.
I appreciate that.
Great. Right this way. Stephen has told you much about what he's been doing here, but he's working on the CIR, short for Cerebral Impulse Relay. It's a lot like an advanced MRI machine. You know, I must admit, I'm not much of a science person. I'm more of a big picture kind of a guy.
Well, what's the big picture of?
Stephen?
Well, our hope is to help patients suffering from things like Alzheimer's disease, stroke, and dementia. Recover from memory loss.
Give them back that part of their lives before they've really lost it. Please.
Valentine's goal seemed like a noble one. But I couldn't help thinking he was only telling me part of the truth.
Since an MRI is basically a giant magnet, no one's allowed to bring anything metal into the lab. To introduce you to the Cerebral Impulse Relay, or CIR, but we like to call it CIR. Have a seat. Oh, not to worry, she's not even online yet. We're still working out some of the kinks. But after the system's integration test, she'll be up and running.
Maybe some other time.
Count on it.
That ring came from Balin. He made a point of leaving it to you. Why would you pawn it in the first place?
I tried to buy it back.
And this Valentine beat you to it. You know, this... this ring is important. More than you know.
What do you mean?
You should have told me sooner, that's all.
Well, I would have if I'd known where you were.
Well, you know what? What's done is done. So what did you find out about Valentine?
That he must be hiding something. And there's enough security at Matacorp to hide whatever it is he's hiding.
Well, after Taylor, that's one more person you can't trust.
What is he doing here? What are you doing here?
He wants to help us.
Like you said, boss, Kyle's running out of people he can trust.
Help us do what?
Get answers. Valentine invaded my home, my family, and my privacy. I don't know what he's doing with my ring, and I don't know what he wants with me or the Traegers.
So what do you want to do?
want to get my ring back.
I'm glad you came.
Well, it's important for Jesse.
Come on in.
Thanks, Uncle.
See you in an hour.
Right.
I like your glasses.
Yeah? I lost my contacts.
Well, you should lose them more often. You look great.
Thanks. Bye.
We have to worry about are here, here, and here. We can disable those, assuming they're on the same circuit. Then there are motion detectors, double redundant ID interfaces, and retina scanners. What's the matter?
I'm just wondering where he comes in.
Don't worry about yourself, boss.
No,
wrong. I have to worry about you because you could get me killed.
We all have to work together on this.
We have one shot. One opportunity. The systems integration test is the only time we know where Valentine will be, when he'll be there, and that he'll have to take his ring off. That's our window. It's tomorrow or nothing.
I don't know. I'm just seeing weird things.
Weird how?
I have this memory of being in a fire. And I asked my sister about it, and she said there wasn't any fire.
Sometimes it helps to draw the images. It may help to clarify some things.
You want to give it a try?
Don't worry how it looks. Just draw what you feel. Did someone teach you to draw that way?
No. Am I doing it wrong?
No, no. Go on, you're doing fine.
Are you sure this will fool Matacor's retina scan?
Well, as long as Kyle can upload it into his security system.
The image is clean. Amanda, you got my message.
Yeah, I got the tickets. Totally scored the orchestra seats.
Are you all right?
Yes. I'm sorry, but something came up.
What?
Something important.
It happens.
I promise I'll make it up to you.
Don't worry about it. It's no big deal. I better go.
Mom, you got a minute?
Sure.
I need to talk to you. Strictly confidential.
Okay.
So you're not my mom, you're my therapist.
understand he has cancer.
Oh, no. Oh, Josh, I'm so sorry.
I finally met a girl that I like. I mean, she's awesome. She likes to play G-Force. She loves zombie movies. The unrated ones you think I don't watch. And I want to help her through this, but she won't let me talk to her about it.
What would you say to her if you could?
I don't know. Something to make her feel better.
You may not have to say anything to do that. Andy might just need you to hang in there with her. And if the time comes and she wants to talk, you'll be ready.
Okay, well, I can bring it home with me.
I can pick it up.
It's kind of important, and I'm not that far away.
Well, I'm heading into the systems integration task. I can have security let you in.
Thanks.
I'm turning back now.
Are you sure you want to do this?
Yeah. Are you?
Absolutely.
Can I take a message?
I'm calling from the Stratford Hotel. Mr. Traeger stayed here last weekend, and it seems he left his contact lenses in his room.
My dad doesn't wear contacts.
Are you certain? He was the last guest to stay in that room.
Wrong number. Okay.
Just hoping the test goes as well as it did in the simulations.
Well, you'd be fired if it doesn't. Kidding. But Hollander's out on her ass.
Mr. Ballantyne's office.
I've got a package down here for Mr. Ballantyne that I need a signature for.
I'll be right down.
Thanks.
Once I get inside Ballantyne's office.
And your password, sir?
I'll be able to access the Matterport mainframe. That'll give me complete control of all the building's video cameras, doors, and retina scanners. I'll be able to switch the image of Fox's retina with Ballantyne's. And you know where you'll be.
So the cops can deal with him.
Get off me, man! I didn't do anything!
Truth is out there! Resistance is futile!
You have a package here from Mr. Ballantyne?
Thank you, Mr. Ballantyne.
You have to practically break my arm.
I'll have a look at it.
Why not just taser me?
I considered it. Don't mess this up.
That's exactly what I'm gonna do.
Copy, Smith.
Governor Smith?
Yeah, we got a report of a disturbance in the North B stairwell.
Copy that.
Be detained, and so will the assistant. Foster, good to go. Seven, 81227. My code name at Zizzix. What did Ballantyne have to do with Zizzix?
How many times do I have to tell you it's a family emergency?
Well, he's in the middle of a software test.
Fine, I'll wait.
I had no idea what I'd find on Valentine's computer. But once I was there in front of it, I had to take advantage of the opportunity. 781228. I thought the experiment at Zizix had ended with me.
Well, it looks like you two have your jobs for another day.
Is that a congratulations?
I think so.
What's wrong?
I need to talk to you in private.
Let's go to my office.
Excuse me. Of course.
Looks like someone's upset over some contact lenses.
And he's headed your way. Get out now.
Mr. Valentine, there appears to have been a security breach.
You can tell me.
Are you having an affair with Emily?
Why would you think that?
The hotel called. The one you stayed at on your business trip? They said you left your contact lenses in the room.
I don't wear contacts.
I know, but Emily does.
Oh, honey, the hotel made a mistake.
I'm just afraid you did.
Nothing happened.
I've seen how you act when she calls. You get all happy and excited.
We work together. She understands what I do.
Does she understand that you're married?
No. Oh. I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Excuse me.
No problem.
That guard is Kyle's handler.
Did you get the ring?
No, we gotta get out of here.
Wait, where's Fox?
He's coming. There he is.
Valentine's headed this way. Wait, what?
Is he close?
Yes, we gotta go!
Can you stop the doors from automatically retracting?
I can't.
MacGyver reruns.
The problem seemed complex, but the math was a simple mix of algebra and geometry. The angle of the incident equals the angle of reflection on the Matacorp logo.
What are you doing? Kyle!
Kyle, come on, man.
That gave me Valentine's distance. Distance divided by the time told me that he'd reached the elevator in...
3, 2, 1. Do it now!
Take the ring and all this would have been for nothing.
But Foss...
He wanted you to get that ring back.
I hope it's worth it.
This one, but the others got away.
Save in the room 237.
Move it.
Kiss for Mommy.
I missed you.
Oh, I missed you more. Is this me?
No, that's my new friend.
Your new friend?
Yeah, she made me these.
Okay, sweet. Let's go.
I
worries. Did you have fun? Doing whatever you had to do?
I wish I could have gone to the concert with you.
It's okay. I understand. Actually, I don't understand. One minute you're thrilled to spend time with me and all excited to go to the concert, and then you cancel without telling me why. You say it's important, but you won't tell me why it's important. I know what's going on.
You do?
I rushed you into this. Admit it, now you're having doubts.
I do have doubts. But...
Well, fine, if that's the way you feel, then there's something I really need to tell you
about. No. Amanda, I have doubts about everything in my life. Except how I feel about you.
Mr. Valentine, your appointment is here.
Send him in. Since the finally meet you, Mr. Taylor.
Pleasure.
We had a little security breach. Someone stole my ring, but it's being taken care of.
It had better be.
No need for alarm. It was just a heirloom from my late father.
An heirloom. That heirloom is a Latinock ring.
People in your rings. Forgive me if I don't lose any sleep over a glorified pledge pin.
You really don't have any idea how important that ring is. Do you?
Adam Balin's secret had been locked inside this box for 15 years. almost as long as I've been alive. Would his secrets provide the answers to my own, or simply raise more questions? There was only one way to know for sure.